Good morning.
Good morning.
Ayana McLennan and Michael DeMatos, week of number one. We're here to win.
Good day.
Good morning.
We're couple number two. My name is Winston. This is my fiance Natasha. And we aim here to win. We don't win. We come to enjoy ourselves.
Yay!
We got this.
Right, we got this.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Sandy Kumagara.
Come
inside. We stop at number three, and we are here to enjoy ourselves.
My name is Rayvon Johnson. Stop number three. We're here to win. And we ain't going home without win.
Hi, good morning. My name is Lata Eben. This is Jason Blackett. Couple number four. We are to win and enjoy the trip.
This is covered with a canopy, so it will be a bit cool for you. And it's a nice, easy, and the trails are wide enough. So the bus is going to be cutting you, right? So you're going to go very slow and enjoy this walk. Enjoy the walk. Right?
Leaving the country and left my fiance behind, knowing that she alone is at home. I mean, I'm going to the detriment, but you know, this is the most difficult time I had. Knowing that it's a family, I'm trying to get them because of the situation, I had to leave, but you know, try to make things better. This is the only difficult time I had.
We're young, trying to build life, and as a couple, when you get a person together, and then you have to pick up a new, when you're there together, you know, when he left, it's something that I have to deal with the situation at home. So,
the thing that gets me most upset would probably be when I'm trying to get a point over to him in a calm fashion, but he probably misinterprets it, and then we might get into a kind of a big, we're gonna go off track instead of what I was trying to see. But that's the only thing I think that, because my point doesn't reach him, that's the only thing that gets me really upset.
That is what gets to me about her, because sometimes when she's trying to go to these things, how she would try to do it, how she would approach it, would seem, I would feel like there is a problem, or she has a problem, and I would feel kind of offended and try to defend myself or something along that line. Can't go.
Well, first of all, I'm working at teacher training college, and I used to like go out and do extra work to get the extra delivery of canto. So one day I was working at Oriental on a canto, and she and three friends were going to be planting chocolate. So they stopped, one of our friends stopped to get after my friend, and I saw she along with her friend. Like they're talking and they're watching this. I said like these girls talking something about me. So when they're going get plan and they come over, they stand up and did they get off and so on. I wasn't get off and I was just the easy buying. So when she ready for left, I said, man, and I asked her, you could do one thing for me. She turned around and she said, where is it? I said, just want to leave your phone number. And she left the number. When I call her the night, the mother answered the phone. I cut off the phone. Because I said, what? Mommy? So I cut off all the phone. And then she called back. And she asked me, why cut off the phone? I said, me know who's the big lady answering the phone. So she said, it's your mother. And Martin Fike cut off with your mother also. Anytime I call mother, when we start talking to one another, we reach one another, start going out, and life start to progress on.
She gave me everything that I want. Everything. She hide nothing from me. She just gave me that courage to go on. Everything. And I believe in her. I love her.
I love staying with her. When I'm broke, being a mother, I always have to say, I love it like I can't stop singing. It's so playful, that's what my children love. I will tell them. Never have a chance. It's called life.